This video is called Factoring Polynomials. You can see here we have a polynomial with three terms, 3x to the third, negative 12x squared, and a positive 15x. And we have to just go one step further from the previous video. To factor it, think of it as dividing things out because we want to make things simpler. Or smaller, it would be another way to think about it. There's simply two steps. Step one, you'll find the GCF, which is what you did in the previous video. And step two, we just have to figure out what's left after we take out that greatest common factor. So for the GCF, remember x to the third is x, x, and x. X squared, you have two of them. And 15x, you just have one. Then ask yourself, what's the biggest number that could divide out evenly from 3, 12, and 15? Well, it would be a 3. And how many pairs of x's do I have to pull out? One from each group. And if I try to do a second from each group, I get stuck right there. So 3x would be the GCF. Step 2 says to put the GCF in front of the parentheses. So 3x in front of parentheses and then put inside what would be left. So put the GCF in front of parentheses and put inside the parentheses what would be left. Well, how many terms did we start with? 1, 2, 3. So you need to make sure, it's really important, that when you are factoring, you have three slots or three placeholders, you could say. So now think about it. Three times what, which we'll put right here, would get me back to 3. Well, 3 times 1. And now if I've got an x, that's really like having x to the first power. So how many x's, if I've got 1x right here, how many x's do I need here to get back to x to the third? You need 2 of them, so you'd write x squared. 2 plus 1 gets you back to that 3. All right, then ask, 3 times what, which will put me right back here, will get me back to a negative 12. Well, 3 times a negative 4 would give me negative 12. And how many x's do I need in this case? If I have 1 here, how many do I need right here to get me back to x squared? You need 1 of them, because the 1 plus 1 gets you back to the 2. All right, we're almost done. We just have to do this last placeholder. And simply ask yourself, 3 times what gets us back to a positive 15? Well, if you thought positive 5, you're on the right track. And then here, I already have an x. Do I even need to put an x here? I don't think I do, because I already have 1x, and I only need to get back to 1. So I actually won't put anything there. So this would be my factored answer. Now you can check your work. You can know you've done it right if you apply the distributive property and see if you get back to the beginning. 3x times 1x squared is 3x cubed. 3x times a negative 4x is negative 12x squared. And 3x times 5 is a positive 15x. If you get back to where you started, so if this answer is where we started, we know we've done it right. And it looks like these two match, so we know that this is our factored answer. Let's try this one, 8x squared minus 12x. Well, step one is find the GCF. Well, x squared, there's really 2x's. Negative 12x, there's 1. What's the biggest number that can divide out of 8 and 12? Well, I think that would be a 4. And then how many x pairs can come? 1x pair. Now we have to fill in what's left. Remember, since we started with two terms, we need placeholders for two terms. And now let's figure this out. 4 times what, which I'll put right here, would get me back to 8. If you thought 2, you're on the right track. And now remember, this guy is really x to the first. So how many x's do we need? If we've got an x here, how many x's do I need here to get back to x squared? You need 1. All right, then ask, 4 times what gets me back to a negative 12? Well, it'd be 4 times a negative 3 gets me back to negative 12. Since I already have an X here, I don't need to put another one here because my final answer only needs one and I already have one. So this would be the factored form of 8x squared minus 12x. I want to be thorough and check my work, so I'm going to do the distributive property. 4x times 2x is 8x squared. 4x times a negative 3 is minus 12x. Since this matches with where I started, I know I factored it right. It's kind of like you start with your problem, you factor or divide everything out, so you broke it apart, and then you put it back together again. And by multiplication, it's a circular thing. It's a way to check to see if you've done this right. All right, this one, 6m cubed, it'll be m, m, and m, minus 12m squared, that'll be two of them, minus 24m, which is just one. So I can see I only have one set of m's to pull out. And then ask yourself, what number can divide out of a 6, a negative 12, and a negative 24 easily? What's the biggest number that could do it? And it would be a 6. So the GCF is 6m. Now I have to fill in my parentheses with what's left. Since I started with three terms, I need placeholders for three terms. All right. So hopefully you're starting to see the pattern. 6 times what gets me back to 6? It'd be 6 times 1. If I have 1m here, because remember this is m to the first, how many m's do I need to get back to m to the third? Be m squared. 6 times what gets me back to negative 12? Be a negative 2. And how many m's do I need? I've got 1 here, so how many do I need here to get back to m squared? I would just need 1. And then to finish, 6 times what gets me back to a negative 24? It'd be minus 4. And since I already have 1m here, and I only need 1, we can leave this blank. So this would be my factored answer. And I am going to go ahead and check it. So I'm going to do the distributive property. 6m times 1m squared would be 6m cubed. 6m times a negative 2m will be a negative 12m squared. And 6m times a negative 4 is negative 24m. That gets me back to where I started, so I know I factored everything correctly.